Committees are formed, there are a number of committees that are in the Parliament, and there are joint standing committees which are made up of members of both Houses of Parliament. In the Legislative Council we also have references and legislation committees, and they are just made up of members of the Legislative Council. In the instance of the Child Abuse Inquiry, that was a joint committee, and they are formed in each Parliament. Members are selected by the various parties. They elect the members that go on, or they nominate members to go on to those various committees. And it was just, it happened to be that Frank and I both were members of the Family and Community Development Committee, which looks at those family and social issues that affect Victorians. So the government can call for a reference or ask for an inquiry to be conducted, and the committee's role is to undertake that inquiry, and they will be given a set of terms of reference which are what the government wants the committee to look at. They're the guidelines, if you like, of what they would like to, the issue that they've given the committee to look at. They'll give them a time frame, and then they'll want a report, which is then a report that is then tabled in the Parliament and in the joint committees. The government has 6 months to then respond to any recommendations that the committee might make. So it's a collective group of MPs that come together, work together on a reference that is given to them, and develop a report, table that report, and allow government to comment and make and then legislate or take up those recommendations, whatever they may be.